How come he was what? Not the pool sheets. What's up? What's up? I don't know where he is. Report, what? What did he just do? Did he just come on stream and dab?
Alright, what's up?
So, Seba, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm some scrub that didn't make it out of full, so I have nothing to do right now. Yeah, I got beat by this guy, Dan.
So. Oh, the diddler beat you?
Yeah. Oh, he plays Rob.
Rob, yeah. And he has a Pikachu that he might try on Moldrift there. But the Pikachu is absolute garbage. I insist, it's terrible. Yeah, he's gonna go Rob. So as I was saying, he has trouble against all of us DDDs, but we're all, like, the three of us, Apollo, Hellpack, and myself, we're, like, really aggressive. Moldrifter is not. He's the opposite of aggression. He's, like, very campy,
yeah,
very annoying.
Yeah, he's gonna fish for those grabs all day.
I root for him because my love for DDD is that strong, but if I love DDD any less, I would never root for Moldrifter. He's the sweetest guy, too. He's a really nice guy. The biggest scumbags, gameplay-wise, are always the nicest people in real life. Mar is playing against Chief. Oh, is that Jonathan? What up, Jan? Oh, is that Capitulize? Okay, Doctor, please. You're embarrassing me, man. Capitulize probably knows that Dandizzle is his biggest fan. Dandizzle is part of the Capitulize fan club. It's a competing organization to the Sosa fan club that I'm the leader of.
Alright, who's gonna camp harder here? That's the real question.
Who's gonna camp harder? Absolutely, without a doubt, Moldrifter.
Oh,
it will always be Moldrifter. Moldrifter's gonna roll to one end of the stage, and then he's gonna waddle on the ground. Not in the air like you're supposed to. He's gonna throw him from the floor, which is very punishable, and no one ever punishes it, and Moldrifter wins. Dolphin. This is a classic Nebulous track on this stage. It's been on a lot of our builds. Oh man. Yeah, this is gonna last a very long time. I'm actually upset that I'm commentating.
Dreamland
is coming up, I'm pretty sure. I really don't know, honestly, what Moldrifter's gonna win on when he's gonna ban. Winners. Semis. This is winner semis. For those not in the know.
And that was the first song. 1 minute 50 seconds.
Oh, really?
Oh,
this is awful. I hate my life. Yeah, this is rough. I wanted my man Seba to come here and commentate an entertaining match before he leaves. He has to commentate Moldrifter. This is punishment for sure. This is what you get for not making it out of pools.
Nah, that's all good.
That's the Moldrifter punishment. Oh boy. Taunt cancel into downward toss waddle, dude.
What the hell? That was a hell of a long grab.
Yeah. Grabs are gonna play an interesting part in this set. Look at that wave dash! That was a Moldrifter wave dash. It's the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. I love this guy. With all my heart. Ooh. Oh, DDD's F2 sounds so good on these headphones.
So much aerial mobility, but if he just messes up once, he's gonna get grabbed.
Yeah, and also if he does too many of those aerial dashes and then gets hit by any random fair from DDD, then now he's out of his, you know, his dashes and he's gonna get edgeguarded easily. Oh, Moldrifter did an SDI, ASDI on the up smash, so he wasn't close enough to get a shield grab. Oh, okay, okay. The Waddle Doo bounced off of a shield, so it wasn't active anymore. Otherwise, it would have definitely hit a long time ago.
I'm trying to be entertaining and like not stay silent the entire time, but they're throwing a lot of Waddle Dees, a lot of lasers.
It's not your fault, dude.
I don't know what to say.
No, don't worry about it. Just do the best you can with Moldier 3 on stream. Oh, that was actually pretty good. DDD can't sweet spot, so you can throw aerials, hard-hitting aerials, or up smashes even, above the ledge, and DDD will fly into it.
Yes, please give the DDD knowledge, because I don't have any.
I only have knowledge because I play the character. If it was any other character, I wouldn't know shit. Gordo the wrong direction. Oh, that was me. I don't want to go down that path of if that was me, because I'm going to be doing that all set. But after that down throw, he down threw Dan Dizzle off stage and he could have went out there.
You think they're actually going to time each other out?
Oh my god, Seba with the important questions. I'm really afraid that's going to happen. And then a lot of good matches aren't going to be able to be played on stream. Well, this is going to take another good hour. Let me check bracket. See where my man Royals is. Royals has to play the winner of Governor and Crazy Halo. Vari and ADCT have to play. They're playing right now, actually.
I don't want
to
drive away all the Royals stream viewers.
Royals is waiting. He's waiting on a set, so he might be on stream next with Governor or Crazy Halo, who's a snake. Oh. I wasn't seeing the percentage. DDD lives for a very long time, but...
Yeah, he died at 140 to an up air.
140? Yeah, 140 is okay. On this stage, it's... That's alright. That's a great up air, too. Rob's up air, so... It makes sense. But now he's at a decent stock deficit. Yeah, DDD has to do a lot of work to kill Rob right now. Dash attack from too far away is not gonna work. Very, very much so. Rob's at 136, but he's heavy. So he's not gonna die anytime soon.
Yo, his shield is so small right now.
Sorry, guys. I just tapped away. That was good Waddle. Do a Waddle upwards to cover some options. But all he does is grounded Waddles. He doesn't do nearly enough aerial Waddles. Watch and learn in the chat. Did Watch and Learn leave?
Where's my nigga Spencer?
I don't see him. He might have left.
Alright, Dan Dizzle is not gonna commit because he has to leave.
Yeah.
Force to go in.
He probably wants to. That should be the plan. If he does something dumb and just like goes in, Moldrift can swallow side. Lots of crazy things. Bolt Drifter isn't the greatest shield grabber.
Point blank laser is really scary right there.
Yeah. Point blank laser actually has like an extra, like a different hitbox. Like there's a... Oh, sorry about that. There's a hitbox like right in front of the eyes. And it hits pretty hard. You can see that little fizzle when he does it really close. Yeah, that actually hurts. It like does some fire damage too. Yeah. Oh, that was a good power shield, even with a small shield. And DDD's shield is actually smaller than it's supposed to be. It doesn't cover his whole body, even at full shield.
It's a pretty big body, though.
It's a big body, yeah. But there's other characters with smaller bodies and the shield, and like bigger bodies, I mean. And the shield covers them entirely. Oh, that was good. That was great. He can lose right now. Up air, and re-grab ledge.
60.
Now it's 14. Totally doable. That was a very bad dash attack.
Dan
Dizzle is not the biggest fan of DDD. So he's gonna enjoy any pop off he can get.
He's definitely in sync with that Rob up throw.
He is Rob right now. Yeah, the damn pop off is nuts.
Oh yes, we don't get Dreamland, thank goodness.
Oh, no Dreamland, something quicker. Watch it still go, like, down to 3 minutes.
is a very huge mental game right now, but who wants to commit to going in like with those air dashes or waffle dashes right now? It's kind of like a game of chicken.
Yeah, it is. It's pretty scary. You have to be very careful with how you place your waddles, but Moldrifter does what he wants when he wants to. A was already too high a percent to be living at on this stage.
Rise. Let's go, Rise.
Dan Dizzle is being very smart and recovering high because TDD can't really get up there in time without committing to something like an upbeat.
Yeah, and you know, DDD is very slow in the air. He doesn't get up very high very quickly, and he doesn't go left and right very quickly either. He has very low aerial drift, so DDD has to hard, you know, commit whether he wants to catch you high or catch you low. What's it? Yeah, Snake. Oh, Hispanic. What? He looks Hispanic. He looks very Hispanic. Warriors wants to know how crazy Halo looks. I'm telling him he looks Hispanic. Yep.
Yo, Crazy Halo!
I told Royals that Crazy Halo looks Hispanic, and he went up to Crazy Halo right away.
Oh!
He found him immediately.
Moldrifter caught him drifting out, and so he was DIing out of that forward air and died at 90%. That's unfortunate.
90%? Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. Oh, shit, he wasn't dead. He hit him with the beams. Oh.
I don't really have much knowledge. I guess that means I have to be an entertaining or hype commentator, but I don't know how to do that with this matchup.
Oh, no, that's alright.
Maybe I should.
No one really needs to be entertaining or hype when Moldrifter is playing.
Maybe I'll just yell after everything.
I mean, it might do something,
oh
but.
Oh my god, a down smash! Oh my god! Oh my god, forward!
Forward air?
Oh, another forward!
Oh.
Yeah, this doesn't really
save. It doesn't really help, I guess not. I thought it would work! There you go, you see Moldrifter red like a kind of like a mid-recovery or whatever. And
there's definitely a lot of conditioning and reading on whether they're gonna drift forward after they get hit by something like a forward air so it can follow up.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of that going on. Character is what? Gotta watch your mouth, kid. Be careful. The words you say can hurt people. Nair.
Dan Dizzle definitely taking advantage again once it becomes a terrible shield.
Moldrifter also had the lead for a lot of this game, and that can just like end right now. 15%. Although every percent matters on Wario land. But, well, there it is. Moldrifter doing his job, hitting Dan Dizzle before he loses his stock. At this point, you don't need to worry about winning with two stocks. You gotta just take as much. Do as much damage as you can before you die.
Like you said, DDD has such slow aerial mobility, it's hard to follow up on a ROM, especially with all those air dashes.
Yeah, exactly. It's all that fair hit somehow, because this game is bullshit. Dan can do it right here. Oh, fair. Not gonna kill because it's Rob. Rob is pretty heavy. He's a heavy guy.
Just taking the air once more. Oh, version of this?
He needs to not DI back.
Oh, shit. He could have tech that.
Yeah, he could have. Moldrifter is not the type to tech those.
Alright, Keychain, I think I gotta sign off now.
Wait, they're gonna find out right now whether it's best of three and best of five.
No, like, I actually have to go right now.
Alright, all right. Seba.
It's been a pleasure.
It's good commentating with you. Good shit. Oh, hold on, I got it.
Three, two, one, go!
Sorry about that noise, guys. Yeah, they're doing best out of three. Yeah, we're doing top eight, best out of five, I guess. Arrow gave it the go ahead. He's the one in charge of the schedule and all that stuff. Actually, I'm gonna get Nox here. Nox, I need to do my round robin matches. That's what you're waiting on.
Doing bad?
Sorry guys, Muldrifter just lost his stock because he didn't waddle dash with no jumps. When you lose all your jumps, but you're really high, you can waddle dash with no jumps. If you have only one jump left, you can waddle dash with one jump. That's significant because he usually has to use two jumps to initiate the waddle dash. Oh, soft serve. Jesus is a very grounded DD for the most part. And Ripple jumps a lot, obviously, and Muldrifter is very campy. But yeah, the other DDs, LPAG and myself, and even Apollo, we mix it up. I like to think that we're a little more aggressive, but that's kind of getting proven wrong more and more, because the better we get, the campier we get. Like, little by little. Yeah, soft. Don't really judge too much. It's the Muldrifter is his own guy. Oh, that waddle jumped off with an active hitbox. Yeah, Muldrifter is his own guy for sure. I swear to God, if Muldrifter wins this, I have things to do. Hold on, I'll be right back. I'll find me. Oh, Ryzel, for sure. You gotta sand him. You have to sand him. You're not sanding him, you're not doing it right. Muldrifter is not the sandal kind of guy, unfortunately. He's never off stage to sand him. You need to be in the right, you know, sandal position in order to land it. For those of you who don't know what a sandal is, you're not gonna find out. I gotta go. Hold on, I might be back. Oh, Muldrifter fucking wins, holy shit.
He fucking took a game!
Three, two, one, go!
side bets on the timeout? I'm definitely trying to side bet on the timeout.
Watching this set makes me glad I'm a millionaire. I'm so happy. I don't think Project Mass.
Oh, man. You're still in, right?
Oh, yeah.
This is... What?
What you doing? I didn't want to draw. Like, it was just like projectile, and I died. Every single time.
Projectile. Oh, fuck, man. Yeah,
Actually, you're better off actually.
Yeah.
Thank you. Take this.
Why?
I don't know, man. We both suck.
I could have told this little.
Everybody's on the set.